The following dramatization is based on Sonny Bono's autobiography, And the Beat Goes On.
All right, we're back with Sonny Bono. Okay, enough about politics now. Let's get to the good stuff. You're on your fourth marriage. Cher had an Oscar nomination. All right, so where did it go wrong? You were responsible. You molded her. It was your vision. You know, you had the look, you had the sound, you wrote the songs. It was your idea for the TV show. And then one day, bingo, it all went south on you. What happened?
I ask myself that every day.
Oh, you don't, do you?
No, not really. It's just so hard. It's just so hard for two people to be in love and to be partners and to be in show business together.
But it's a good question. How did it happen?
I couldn't sleep at all.
I guess it really started in 1961. Roger Maris broke Babe Ruth's record. Chubby Checker was twisting at the Peppermint Lounge. Alan Shepard was the first American to shoot into space. And I was delivering meat. I hustled the best route in town, past the record companies. Even when I was a kid, music was where I'd go when everything around me was lousy. Life was gray. Music was technicolor.
Turned on the light, I pulled down the shade, went to the kitchen for a bite. Rolled up the shade, turned off the light. I jumped back into bed, it was the middle of the night. The clock downstairs was striking four.
At the time, if you ask my dad, I was a failure. And he was probably right. I couldn't really sing, and I only knew three chords on the piano. But with three chords, I could write a song. Hey, Miriam.
It's the meat man.
This is your lucky day, okay? Last night I wrote a hit song. Now, I'm telling you, you get me into play for Barry, I guarantee he's gonna flip for it.
Sonny, you got a hamburger, I'm buying, but your music stinks.
I still think you're a doll. And that's the way it went. But I never quit trying.
Does Mary have anything to him?
Not yet, but another
hey,
one.
Fellas.
I mean, he's got nothing.
That's good right there.
Okay. All right.
Get that long boom closer to the strings.
Hey, buddy, isn't that Sam Cooke?
Yeah, we're laying down the vocals on something called You Send Me.
So what's shaking?
Ah, oh, nothing. Ah, oh, man, I can't pay him to buy a song.
I told you to see Bumps Blackwell. They need stuff here.
I did. He hated everything.
Look, your songs are good, but you're too anxious. You're like desperate.
Well, yeah, because I am desperate. I'm so broke, buddy. I'm eating fat scraps out of the meat locker.
Yeah, but you can't get crazy if it doesn't happen when you think it should happen. I mean, people can smell flop sweat a mile away. They don't take you seriously.
Meat man.
Yeah, Mr. Roo.
Yeah, I'm putting that song of yours, the High School Dance, on the B-side of Larry Williams' new single, Short Fat Fanny. You got a session tomorrow night. Bumps is producing.
Well, I thought you hated my stuff.
Not everything.
Just one more dance with you before the night is through. We'll dance and dream like other lovers do.
So, what do you think?
Well, I think, you finally got a song recorded.
Oh, what's going on?
Excuse me, I do not want. All right, you help with this again. This man belongs to me.
That fight with Otto, will you send me? They're in real trouble over it.
Why?
Well, Otto wants to keep Sam in gospel, but Sam and Bumps want to release it.
I don't need to hear you send me, man. I know where I'm gonna send you.
It's gonna be a bloodbath.
Right.
To hell with it. We're out. Let's go.
Yeah?
There's an opening here. A&R.
A&R? I'll take it.
First, you got to interview.
Okay, when?
You just did.
A&R, Artisan Repertoire, which meant I was a talent scout, producer, psychiatrist, and babysitter. But none of it applied to Little Richard. He only answered to a higher power.
It's great to see you, Richard. We need to talk. You really gotta fulfill your recording obligations to Mr. Roop.
I did. I already gave him Good Golly, Miss Molly, Long Tall Sally, Lucille. I even gave him my baby.
Your baby?
Yeah, Tutti Frutti. Woo! No buts. Now you tell Art Roop for me he has to fulfill his obligations to me.
I know you feel that way, but you see, you signed a valid contract, and obligation's an obligation.
This is something to think about. Okay.
Okay?
Okay. I just gotta go talk to Jesus.
Did you talk to Jesus?
Yes.
And what did he say?
Well, he said, no, 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 N-O.
I never stopped hustling.
Okay.
Recording for Art during the day, promoting his records, moonlighting as a producer at night. I learned 20 new things a day, but it was never enough.
Would you look at this? To Know Mr. Love, Spanish Harlem, Karina Karina, He's a Rebel. That's four records in the top 20. I mean, you know, I can't stand it. The guy's got a new hit every day. How does he do it?
Because Phil Spector is a genius. We're talking about you. You gotta slow down. You're all over the place. Art is gonna get pissed.
I'm doing my job. I wanna be Phil Spector. I mean, you're happy doing what you're doing.
Well, who says? You think I'm happy pushing buttons all day? Stop complaining. Now, you know what? You need a broad. You need a broad.
No, don't nag, right? I don't have time.
Look, make time. Look, you're not a balanced person. You haven't even been out with anybody since your divorce. Look, I know this girl. I'm gonna tell her to get her friend Melissa. We'll double tomorrow night.
You don't even have to
agree, because it's already happening. We're so late, I hope they're still here.
Oh, what is this place?
I don't know, girls picked it. Ah, there she is.
See? Not bad, huh?
Sonny, this is Melissa.
Hi. Hi, Sonny.
And this is my friend Cher.
Hey.
Hi. You're late. I hate waiting.
It was my fault. I'm sorry.
What is that outfit? Black on black?
Uh-oh. Is that a put-down?
It could be on someone else. I knew it's good.
Let's dance.
Yeah, sure. So, she's cute, huh?
No, Melissa, yeah, she's cute.
Is it my imagination, or are we the only guys in this place?
What, huh?
We are the only guys in this place.
What? I don't know. I'm both kids. Maybe this is where the kids hang out.
You don't think they're, Maybe they're
How would I know? They're your friends.
Well, I don't know. I mean, well, here they come.
I like the way you dance. I mean, both of you, you know.
Yeah? And you're short. What does that give us?
Well, one short guy and one smart mouth.
KRLA 1110 on your dial. The hits just keep on coming.
Hey, Mom.
So?
Wrong what?
To get lucky?
What?
With Melissa.
No. I just took her home.
What, you didn't like her?
Oh, yeah. I mean, she was all right. What about you?
Well, nah. I mean, she has a nice kid, but too much of a hassle.
Hassle? What do you mean?
Well, like, the first time we went out, she's still living with her mother. So I go to drop her off. She makes me park up the block while she gets out of the car, sneaks in through the windows. Now she's living with a bunch of girls in two rooms. I can't even get through the door. TMT, too much trouble.
So, you're not gonna see her anymore?
Bono, you dog.
What?
You like her.
No, you like her. No, not like that, you know? I just thought she was interesting.
This is weird, not interesting. You gotta learn the difference. All right, go ahead. 133 DeLong Prairie, apartment 2.
Meet. What's this I hear you've been moonlighting?
No, Mr. Roop. I mean, just you know, demos, you know, and helping out.
Helping out. Well, you are a helpful guy. Well, here's the thing. Help yourself out of here.
Well, you're firing me?
Put it this way. You're back in the meat business.
Warned you.
Oh, here, let me help you.
Hey.
What are you doing here?
Nothing. Buddy said that,
You were looking for me.
Sorta.
Well, I'm not here anymore.
Well, what do you mean?
Well, I was living with these friends, and the landlord found out there was five of us, so I'm out.
Well, what are you gonna do? You gonna go back home?
Do I look crazy?
So, you got some other place to go, you got a job?
I was working at C's Candy Store, but I just quit.
So you got no job and no place to stay? I mean, if you got nowhere else to go, you can stay at my place.
No, thanks.
Why not? No. You've got it wrong. You're not my type. I don't even find you attractive. No, really. Hey, look, no funny business, I promise.
Well, I can't help with the rent. I'm broke.
Well, that's okay. So am I.
See, I told you, two single beds, huh? No problem.
No problem.
Hey, you remember the other night at the club,
Yeah? So?
Well, I was just wondering,
What? What were you wondering? If I like girls?
Yeah.
Why?
What do you mean, why?
Why? What's it to you? You said no strings, no funny business, so what's it to you? Unless you got plans. Unless that was just crap.
Well, no. I mean, that wasn't... I mean, no, that's not why I... Good night.
Well... It's none of your business. But I like guys. If I'm going to
stay here. We gotta get some things straight.
You hum in the morning. I can't stand that.
Why? I like to hum. It's a new day. I'm happy.
Well, I'm not. It takes a lot to get me happy, and a new day doesn't do it.
Okay, no humming. Anything else?
We gotta be truthful with each other.
Huh. I'm truthful.
Well, I'm not. I lied to you.
Well, you're a lesbian?
No. My real name isn't Cher.
Oh, okay. Okay. What is it?
Sherilyn Sarkeesian LaPierre.
Huh. Cher's cool.
This is real food. You can cook.
Well, yeah, I'm Italian. We cook. So, anything else?
Well, the second thing I told you that wasn't true is I'm not 18.
How old are you?
Not 18.
Well, 17? 16? Oh, wait a minute. Wait. You're 16, Sharon, and you're living with me? Oh, I could go to jail.
Relax. I'm 17. I had a birthday last week.
Yeah, well, how do I know that?
Because I'm telling you.
Some guys know when they're in trouble.
Hmm.
Some are slow learners.
Here, grab your stuff.
Hey, why? What?
My mother's on her way over.
Well, so?
I told her I was living with a stewardess, and she's gonna be here any minute. You gotta get your things out of here.
Hey, well, what am I supposed to do with this stuff, huh? And may I remind you this apartment is mine, in case you forgot?
Well, take them to the garage. Here.
Oh, hey, you know, I gotta...
That's also yours.
You've got some nerve.
Oh, and can you just wait in the garage till after she leaves? She's only coming to check up.
Well, yeah, of course she's checking up. I mean, who would believe a stupid stewardess story? You know, you should have told her you're living with a French millionaire.
And then she'd stay for dinner.
Phil Spector, The Wall of Sound.
What do you think? Is it dumb enough? Is it dumb enough?
Ah,
dumb. Rock has to be dumb to be good. Who the hell are you and how did you get in here?
I'm Sonny Bono. My friend Buddy Black called about an appointment for a job.
A job? What do you think you can do for me, Sonny Bono?
Oh, anything. Anything at all.
Not in the anything business. I'm in the record business.
Yeah. Why don't you pause it,
huh? It's not there yet.
No, I know. I mean, Phil Spector is the record business.
The girl's voice accords you singing like this. Got it? Just lay a little heavier on fours. Bum, bum, bum. Bum, bum, bum.
Mr. Spector,
Harold, you're on the stand.
Phil, see, now, I've been studying your company, and what I think is that you need a West Coast promotion man. Now, because your company's special, I mean, it shouldn't be handled with other labels. You don't get the right treatment. So now, see, me, I would represent just your label.
You're good, Bono. So is the idea. I like it. But see, Sonny Bono, any guy who works for me, in whatever capacity, has to be able to do everything, be everywhere.
Oh, no, see, I can do everything and be everywhere.
Yeah? I bet you can. Okay, you got a month. You run with the product, and if I'm happy, you got another month. But see, Sonny Bono, it's important for me to be happy. Going again?
Take three.
That's gold coming out of those speakers. Hmm?
Tonight you're mine completely. You give your love so sweetly. Tonight the light of lovers in your eyes. But will you love me tomorrow?
You just barge in?
You're really good. I mean, you've got a great voice, you know, we should record you.
Get a job first.
I did, and hey, why do you always put me down?
Oh, well, don't take it personally. So what kind of job?
Well, I just sweet-talked Phil Spector into hiring me as his personal promotion man.
Yeah, right, Phil Spector.
Yeah. Well, hey, you don't want to believe it, don't. But I'm taking you out to dinner to celebrate just the same. Better get ready.
I can't wait to have a lobster too.
Big star.
Hey, Tony, it's a big night for me now. I'm working for Spector, huh?
That's great, Sonny. I'll have some wine sent over with my compliments. And feel free to sign if you want to.
Thanks.
Enjoy.
There, see, he believes me.
I never said I didn't.
Well, yeah, but you never said you did. You know, the problem with you, Cher, is you got no faith. I mean, look around. Okay, there, see that guy there? That's Colonel Tom Parker. That's Elvis's manager, huh? And over there, that's Sam Cooke. See, everybody who's anybody comes here. And now I'm here. I'm here signing for the check.
I want to be a star.
What kind of star?
I don't care. And I don't have all that much time. I'm not going to live very long.
Cher, come on.
No, I have these premonitions that I'm not going to live very long.
How long are we talking?
30. I might not even make it that far.
Oh, Cher, you're crazy.
I know. When I was a kid, I used to practice signing my autograph. So, before I die. Before it's too late, you know.
I'm gonna keep this.
Okay.
Yeah, no, for when you are a star. Yeah, I'm serious. I think you could be. I mean, you see how everyone looks at you when you walk into a room?
People will look at anything.
No. I'm telling you, you've got it. I mean, when I see you at the house and I hear you sing, it's amazing.
Do you think I'm pretty?
Pretty? Well, no, your nose is too big. But no. I mean, a million girls are pretty. You don't want pretty. That's nothing. No, you're interesting and you're beautiful and you've got your own style. You're gonna be somebody. I don't know how or when, but it's gonna happen. Way before you're 30.
That's great, thanks boys. Where's Bono?
Right here.
Don't hover. I want to hear a scratch vocal. Where are the girls?
Well, they're up the street eating.
But I want to hear it now. Didn't you say she could sing?
What are you kidding? What do you hear her?
Well, then get her in there.
Cher, come on. Cher, come on. Cher. What? She was just taken by surprise, Phil. Hey, come on, Cher. You're holding up the take, huh? Phil's gonna get crazy. Cher? Are you crying?
No.
Oh,
Why are you crying? This is good.
No, it's bad. I can't do it. My throat is closed.
Well, no, it's not. You're talking.
No, for singing, it's closed. I can't. I keep hearing this voice inside my head saying, sing. Who do you think you are? You're going to make an ass out of yourself.
I know that voice. You know, it says the same thing to me. It says, Bono, you're a bum. You're a fake. You're nothing. So you know what I do? I say, well, so are you, or you wouldn't be hiding behind that creepy little voice.
I can't. I want to, but I can't.
Okay. We'll both go in the studio. I'll be right there with you. And then you'll just pretend like you're in the apartment and you're just playing around. Like you always do, huh? What do you say? Okay, well, look at this. Now we're in the living room, huh? And there's the chair and the window, and it's just you. Huh? Just you.
I love how your eyes close whenever you kiss me. And when I'm away from you, I love how you miss me.
Just you, me, and the sound.
I love the way you always treat me tenderly. But darling, most of all, your heart beats whenever I hold you. I love how you think of me without being told to. I love the way your touch is always heavenly. But darling, most of all,
was gonna happen.
I didn't. But it sort of snuck up on me. I mean, you know, there you were every day when I'd come home. And then one day you were out with your mother or something. And I came home. The house felt so sad. Not just empty. Sad.
But darling, most of all, I love how you love me.
Oh no. Don't say anything.
What?
Hello, Mother.
You must be the stewardess. May I see you privately?
What the hell is that in there?
That's Sonny.
Everything has a name, Sherilyn. Is that what you were planning to bring home for me?
I wasn't planning to bring him anywhere. You barged in. And he's not for you, Mother. He's for me.
No, Sherilyn, he's not.
You don't even know him. He's a big record producer. He's doing things for me.
He can't even comb his own hair. What is he gonna do for you?
He's gonna make me a star.
Oh, Sherilyn, you are such a baby.
You never believe anything I say.
You know, if I have to, Sherilyn, I will have him arrested for corrupting a minor.
You dare. You just dare. Ignore her, Sonny.
So nice to meet you, Sonny.
I,
She could have me arrested. You do know that.
Oh, stop. That's my mother. She just blows off steam, but she never does anything. Except ruin my life.
Hey. She's not gonna ruin anything for us. I swear to you, Cher, when you're a star, she's gonna worship the ground you walk on. Okay. Phil, wait a minute, Phil. Your coleslaw.
Oh, yeah, great.
Listen, Phil, we didn't finish talking about recording Cher, you know. I mean, you heard her. I don't have to sell you on how great she is.
That's right, you don't. And signing X is not in your job description. Either I can define your job, or you can.
Okay, close your eyes. Close. Okay, open them.
Sonny, oh my God.
Yeah, you like it?
Oh, I am never taking it off.
Hey, come on, I got something else to show you. Okay, here we go. Huh? What do you think? I'm gonna write us hits on this, Cher.
Get your money back, son. Whatever you paid, it was too much.
Are you kidding? I stole it. $85 only has three missing keys.
Well, that's okay. You only know three chords.
Hey, those three chords are gonna put us on top.
So now you're gonna tell me what Spector said today?
You know, Phil, I mean, what does he ever say? Hey, look, we can't depend on him. I mean, by the time he gets around to focusing on you, you're gonna be pushing 30 and I'm gonna be in a home. We gotta put things together ourselves.
Thanks for the ring, son. It was really sweet.
My first plan was to write and produce songs for her to record alone. But it didn't work out that way.
Pretty baby, please don't go.
It's good, I think.
No, I know it's good. In fact, I borrowed some money from Buddy, and you're gonna record it. You're single, just you, tonight.
Never had a brother, a heart that knew my dad. Been in town for 18 years. You're the only boy I've had.
I can't, son. You have to sing with me. It's only gonna work if we sing it together.
Okay. She was afraid to sing alone, so we became a duo. All right, I'll tell you what. You start, and I'll come in on the chorus. You just sing to me. And from a duo, we became an act.
Maybe I'll be back someday.
ourselves Caesar and Cleo. And I knew if we were going to be noticed, then our look had to be different.
I get to the city, where tears will all be dry. My eyes will look so pretty. No one's going to know I cried. Yes, I'm going away. Maybe I'll be back someday. Baby, don't go. Pretty baby, please don't go.
Great. Thanks. Thank you. Thanks. We're Caesar and Cleo, and the song you just heard. That was Baby Don't Go, and it's our new single, and the song it was just released, and I guess you never heard of it. just jump in here anytime, Cleo. I mean, how come you think they never heard of it?
Because they'd rather bowl. Come to think of it, so would I.
Funny, very sure. I came here to sing, and you want to make jokes, huh? Well, you know, I mean, what you'd maybe rather bowl?
Well, it's better than hearing you sing.
I'm telling you, Sonny, you just got to change the order of the set. I really think so, because this way you start off with more of a bang. But anyway, when you were talking, it really started to cook. All right.
See ya.
I'll call you later.
They hated us.
What? No. I mean, you heard what Buddy said. They started liking us, you know, when we were ourselves. Just Sonny and Cher.
Hi, Brian Stone. This is Charlie Green. We caught the show. Great, just great. And Baby Don't Go is such a hit, we can't believe you don't have a label behind you.
It wasn't such a hit, okay? So why are you pitching us this bull?
My partner exaggerates a little bit, but the two of you got a lot of potential. Caesar and Cleo just need management.
Well, we're Sonny and Cher, and we don't need any management.
But you do need a record deal. What if I told you we could get you one?
With who?
I'm Matt Erdogan, president of Atco Records.
I'd say you were full of crap.
We already played him Baby Don't Go, and he loved it. You sign with us. You got a record deal.
Now you start, okay?
They say we're young, and we don't know. Won't find out until we grow.
And then I go,
well, I don't know if all that's true. You got me, and baby, I got you.
Wow.
Babe we caught was a monster. My goal had always been success. Cher's had been fame. Suddenly, overnight, it seemed we had both. Are you sure this is the one you want?
It's perfect. Can we afford it?
Wow. Would it make a difference?
Yeah. Oh, a phone.
Well.
It's a local call. Mom, hi. I'm calling you from our new house. Okay, it's in Bel Air. Yeah, we've got gates, a big driveway. Oh, and you're not gonna believe this. It used to belong to Tony Curtis. Yeah!
This is unbelievable. I know.
Oh, man.
Yeah. I really missed you out on the road, man.
Yeah, me too. But I read about you, though. The getting thrown out of hotels and stuff.
Yeah. Hey, listen. I'm gonna need someone I trust as a road manager now. You interested?
I don't know, son.
Oh, come on, buddy. I want you to be a part of this. But you were the only one that ever believed in me.
What does Cher think?
It's not her area. I want you.
Working for a friend? I don't know. Maybe I'd rather just be a friend.
Okay, here's the deal. Huh? If we ever think the friendship's going south, we cut bait. Huh?
All right.
We gotta get some furniture.
We can't. We spent everything on the house.
At least it came with the bed.
We pulled it off.
Yeah, we did.
Our money is all been spent.
Babe. I got you, babe.
We rode the wave for a while, and then the business took a left turn. I don't know. Maybe the whole world took a left turn. The Stones were hot, Dylan, Jefferson Airplane, Janis Joplin. People were writing an edgier, grittier sound.
All right, well, son, you know what? Just listen to the Who's new album. I mean, that's the kind of stuff that we should be doing.
Listen, you know, I did, okay? I tried. I just don't write that kind of stuff.
All right, well, you know what? The boy-girl crap just doesn't cut it anymore.
Yeah, well, look, would you just let me handle it, okay? We don't drink, we don't do drugs, we don't protest. I think we're doing something right. We're still making a living, aren't we? Hey, Enzo, eh? Hey, come by. La familia tutta bene.
Bene, e tu?
Bene.
Enjoy.
Hey, you know what, son? Just listen to what I'm saying.
Look, I have listened, okay? And would you just lay off now?
I didn't think they'd let fags eat in here. Hey, sweetheart, huh? Who's the hooker, huh? I didn't think you like girls.
Hey, pal, you want to go? No!
Don't. Nobody's looking. No. You know what? You shouldn't get my husband mad. He's got a lot of friends.
You mean a lot of boyfriends, don't you, sweetheart?
Sonny.
I'll break your face, huh?
Sonny,
you want to keep talking? You want to see something outside?
Sonny.
You got a problem here?
I don't know. Do we? I don't eat with faggots.
That's okay. You're not really hungry. You.
Thanks.
Sonny, we don't need this here.
No, I know, Tony. I'm sorry, but we didn't start it.
I know, but you and Sherry create this kind of thing. Maybe it's best if you don't come back anymore.
What? Well, you know how many years we've been coming here?
Come on.
You treat the other stars in here like this?
They don't get into fights, Sonny.
Come on.
What?
Come on.
No, I'm... I can't believe it. Like we're garbage.
We are garbage. Look at us.
What are you talking about?
What? You didn't see what happened in there. You weren't there.
No, I saw what happened. Two stars walked in and a couple of jerks.
We are not stars, okay? We are freaks. No, we're not even good enough to eat with decent people. Why bother? Our market is gone.
Markets change. It'll come back.
Oh, Sonny, please.
What do you want to do? Huh? You want to just lie down and die? Well, there's only two ways to go right now, up or down, and I'm sure as hell not letting Sonny and Cher go down.
Sonny and Cher, what is that? It's just a thing. It has nothing to do with the real us. Can't you see that?
Try to make me run. Son of a gun now.
I'm sorry. I'm not mad at you. I'm mad at the world, and I'm just taking it out on you. I just hate losing everything.
No, we're not gonna. Hey, sit down. I'll tell you what I've been thinking. We should make a movie. No, hear me out. The Beatles made a film, Elvis made a film.
You know, the Beatles are huge stars. So is Elvis. We can't buy a hit record. Who's gonna back us in a movie?
No, I know, nobody. Unless we do it ourselves. So, what if I write a movie for you? No, starring you, see? The real you. I mean, things that people never got to see or know about you.
Oh, son, it's ridiculous.
Well, why? Why, you always wanted to be a movie star.
Yeah, but that was just what I wanted. It wasn't what I could have.
You don't dream right, Cher. Hey, if I write you a hit movie, I'd be your Prince Charming again.
You were never my Prince Charming. You were my horny toad.
I suppose every jerk who talks English thinks he can write a screenplay. It was damn hard, let me tell you. Especially since I was writing it about Cher. I named her character Chastity. Now, everybody told me I was crazy to put my own money into a movie, but I really believed in her. I was afraid to tell Cher that I hawked the furniture, though.
No, that's not much. Do you know how long I've been sitting in my dressing room?
Look, we've had some problems, Cher.
4 hours. Am I in the next scene?
No, no, we're a little behind.
Then I'm going shopping.
Come on, Cher, what is this? You gotta stay on the set. Every time we have to call you, it takes an extra hour to get you back into makeup and costume. You know, time is money.
Well, what am I supposed to do? Stay trapped in there until they decide they're ready for me?
Yeah, well, that's what actresses do, okay? Look, every penny it costs while we wait for you, it comes out of us, Cher. It's our movie.
No, it's your movie.
Hey, wait a minute. No, wait. What the hell are you talking about? I wrote it for you, huh? You're starring in it. It's all about you.
It's not about me. It's about some jerky vision you have of me, okay? It's not real. I can't get into it.
Wait a minute. Get into it? Now, what the hell does that mean? And what do you know about acting anyway, or scripts, huh? What, you're trying to tell me what's real?
Like I said, it's your movie.
Oh, yeah, sure, look, coming from someone who thought Mount Rushmore was a natural phenomenon, huh? You're trying to tell me how to make a movie?
You know what? Screw you, Sonny.
Big brown eyes, he came my way. I didn't know then what he had. I could tell that he felt bad by the way he looked, that he was sad, oh yeah.
Son, you there? Son, I felt so bad about our... I don't know why. I'll always fight.
Cher, wait, please. I'm an idiot, honey. I don't know why I did that, okay? I didn't even want her. I mean, you're my life, okay? Nothing on earth that could ever threaten that. Please, honey, I just get so scared that I'm losing you. Just please.
Please what? Please forgive you for screwing some secretary? All guys do that, right? What's the big deal, right? Right? By the way, you son of a bitch, I'm pregnant.
Cher? Cher, honey? Honey, are you all right? Cher, please, honey, I just want... Oh, some morning sickness? What, can I get you something?
Yeah, you can get lost.
Cher, come on now. Honey, I've been apologizing for a straight month. I don't know what else to do anymore. Please, honey. It's our baby. Just let me share it. Cher? Okay, you guys. Here it is. I'm on my ass like I never been. I got a movie here. I made it myself. I put my own money into it. My house... My furniture, my life. Now, I tried to sell it. I've been to every distributor in town, and nobody wants it, nothing. So now, Abe, I need you and the other agents to come through for me. I've come through for you. I made William Morris a lot of money. Well, now it's your turn. So you sell this damn movie, and you get me out from under.
Well, Sonny, I'm sorry, but the situation looks bleak.
Guys?
They can't force people to buy it, Sonny.
You're fired. Both of you. Look, I know it's my fault. Okay, I beat myself up day and night, but we gotta try to keep going. And the flamenco gig is all we've got.
Well, then we've got nothing. Because I'm not doing Vegas. It's not what I want. It isn't what I signed on for.
Cher, what did you sign on for?
I believed in you, son. And now...
Do you still love me?
No, son.
No, really, I want to know.
I'll always love you, Sonny. No matter what happens.
Life goes on. And the light.
The beat, try beat.
And the beat goes on. The beat goes on.
What are you doing?
Nothing, just fooling around.
You keep trying and I'm such a bitch, I'm sorry. I'll do the gig.
Yeah, but you hate Vegas. I mean, you understand we'll be the opening act for Pat Boone, not headlining.
I just want the furniture back. And I want us back.
Now, folks, I don't know if you know this, but I have a tough drop up here. I do. It's called... It's called, well, I humbly say it's called carrying the show. And what it is I do the talking. And if you think it's easy, then why don't you just stand here and talk, and I'll look away, and I'll act a little bored, and then I'll play with my hair a little bit, and then somebody can lend me a big nose, and we'll get started.
Keeps me hanging on. Oh, honey, all I ever need is you. You're my first love, you're my last. You're my future, you're my past. And loving you is all I ask, honey.
Yeah, buddy, I finished writing Beat Goes On. Let's set up a session when we get back to LA, huh?
Okay. Gonna go check on the band. Anything else?
Yeah. Let's get a meeting with the networks. I got this idea for a TV show.
TV?
Well, I tried movies.
I'll see you after the show.
Okay.
Hey. You think I'm starting to show?
Show?
The baby.
Wait, we're having a baby? Oh, come here, baby. Hi. It's me, Daddy. I know we've had our problems, Cher. I mean, there's a thousand things I'd like to take back or undo, but I really feel this baby's gonna give us a new beginning. A chance to make things right.
I think so, too.
I want to marry you.
What?
Yeah, a real wedding.
We can't, son. I mean, the press would go nuts. Everybody already thinks we've been married for years.
No, I don't care. I don't care. We'll do it secretly, huh? Hey, here, tonight, after the second show. You don't want to get married?
Come on, Larry.
Shouldn't I change?
No. Let's just do it.
No, I'm wearing the wrong dress.
No, it's fine, really. You're beautiful.
I should have a veil. It's not going to be real if I don't have a veil.
It's real and it's legal. Come on.
I have a sore throat.
Oh, no. Cher. Listen, we're getting married, okay? All right, now let's take my arm. And we're going to walk over to the minister. Huh? And when he asks you, do you, Cher, take Sonny to be your wedded husband? What are you going to say? Huh?
Yes.
Yes.
I love you.
You do? Well, then let's get married.
Come on, hurry. No. Okay, easy step and step. Buddy, you drive and I'll sit back with Cher, okay?
It's cool.
Oh, wait.
Wait.
No,
wait.
I gotta get my camera. I don't want to forget a minute of this.
But no, are you crazy? Look what I look like. No.
You look beautiful. Just one sec. Hold it.
Oh, no. Say hi, baby. Get the baby, not me.
Chastity, son. You brought the sun. And you brought a new life for us.
After the baby was born, we had to go back on the road. Cher hated it.
She likes to watch the Late Show on television. What are those monster movies?
Yeah.
Yeah. And so last night I came to bed, and she was under the sheets, and she was trembling. She was shaking with sheer terror. It was awful.
That's because you were coming to bed.
No. That's not funny. That's not funny. Bill, she's not funny, is she?
Yeah.
No, you'll get yours later.
Yeah, you won't. You know, everything we do together, everything ends up in the show.
So that's what makes it real.
No, that's what makes the show real. What makes our life real?
What? You, me, Chaz? Well, what are you talking about?
I'm saying Sonny and Cher are taking over. There is no us anymore. Maybe we mistook what we had on stage for a marriage. I hate what we're turning into.
What, you think I like the constant put-downs from you, Cher, huh?
I thought it was just part of the act, son. I'll go.
Oh, come on, Cher, look, it'll get better, all right? I'll figure something out.
Here, honey. Come here. Okay, yes. Okay, Mommy's here. Daddy's here.
Cher, just don't give up on us, okay? Just give me a year to pull something off, huh?
Son, you don't get it.
I do, and I know I can do something. I mean, we're this close to the TV show.
Don't. No more dreams, okay? No more fantasies.
Just please, Cher, 1 year. I just need for you to believe in me again.
It didn't take a year. You nervous?
Nah.
Me either.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sonny and Cher.
The beat goes on. The beat goes boom, 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 boom.
Drum keeps pounding. Da-da-da.
take it. Just take it down. Because she didn't know if this was my thing here.
I got rhythm.
Just go ahead, guys. Just bring it down some more. Because she forgot that this is my just take it all the way out. Just take it all. Just take it all the way out. You see, this is the beginning of our first show, and actually this part isn't planned. It's I want to get something off my I want to say a little thing here.
What happened to the show?
No. I want to say one thing by myself. You see, Cher and I, we get compared a lot, and when you're a celebrity and entertainer, people write about you and they talk about you, but somebody said something that really bothered me, and well, they said I sing like a frog, and no, seriously, and so what I like to do, what I want to do on the show is I just like to sing one chorus by myself, you know, and then that way I won't be victimized by gossip, and you people will know the truth, and so that's okay, isn't it, sweetheart? If I just sing one chorus.
Croak your heart out, Froggy. You know what I mean? Just croak it to him.
She, whoa, what's the matter with you?
I think I got a wart.
No, that's not funny. That's not funny.
You a horny toad?
This is a family show. Listen, wait, will you just keep the light on her, please? Because, you know, I, when she gets in these moods like this, I don't know what's going to happen. I just got a hunch that I'm going to be screwed, you know?
I got a hunch you won't. In fact, I'll lay odds on it.
On the biggest high of my life. Gold! Gold! Everything seems so perfect. Gold! I got gold nuggets!
In this kind of weather, everybody gets cold nuggets.
But somewhere during the second season of the show, Cher's attitude began to change. Cher, I've reworked the opening. I want to go over it with you.
Since when?
Hi, Sonny. David Geffen.
Yeah, hi, nice to meet you.
I was just leaving. Have a good show. I'll talk to you soon.
What's going on?
Nothing.
Yeah, nothing.
I wish we were really big, like Dylan or the Stones.
What do you mean big, Cher? We're as big as anyone. We have a hit show on CBS. Why can't you see that? You've been talking to Geffen, Mr. Hotshot Record Mogul?
No. You either get it or you don't.
Well, then, no, Cher, no, I don't get it, okay? So why don't you explain it to me? I mean, you're dissatisfied with everything we have, you know? You hate it when we're working, you're bored when we're not, so what do you want?
I don't know. Something. I'm just confused.
Confused?
Okay, miserable.
Oh, well, yeah, that's great. That's just great. Nothing could be better for us than she's miserable. You know, I don't know what the hell you want me to do, Cher. What more can I possibly do to make you happy? Yeah. What? Hold on. It's Buddy. They want us at Caesars after we finish the contract at the Sahara.
No. No more Vegas. I can't stand it.
They're offering $150,000 a week, Cher.
I don't care. It's too much doing the show all week and then rushing up there. Don't make the deal.
Make the deal.
I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got you, babe.
I got
bless you. Thank you. Thank you. Good night. Thank you. Thank you. Cher, you coming?
I want you to leave the room.
What? Why?
Because Bill is coming up.
What does Bill want? Sure, I'm exhausted.
I want to sleep with him.
Are you crazy?
He's coming up, son, and I want you to leave.
You just walked out? How could you just walk out? That little bastard, he's doing your wife, Sonny. Why are you still sitting here?
Well, what do you want me to do, buddy? You want me to break his legs, kill him, huh? It's not about him. She's trying to tell me something.
Look. Whatever the hell she's telling you, you can't just let it happen. We can't just let it happen. What if this gets back to CBS? You gotta start thinking like that. I mean, this is bigger than...
What's gonna be with us, Cher, huh?
I don't know.
No, I think you do know.
I think I'm in love with Bill.
No, you're not. See, you're just looking for a way to end us. Now, I want to know why.
Why don't you just have a conversation with yourself? You ask all the questions and you answer them.
Look, Cher, we have to talk, okay? Because, you know, we're not some little couple from Pomona who had a marital spat, okay? We have a child, we have a marriage obligation. Sonny and Cher are a business.
You said it. And I'm not in love with a business.
It was over. I really didn't know why. What I did wrong. I mean, we still did our thing, but it was over.
Tell Bob Mackie they want more sequins in the gown.
Involuntary servitude? Yeah. You couldn't file for irreconcilable differences like everybody else?
Son.
But you didn't want to be a star, huh? You weren't happy when I handled everything? What?
No. No, you never let me have anything to say. I was your puppet. Cher, do this. Cher, smile. Cher, look at me.
Sure, fine. Play your favorite role, the victim. Just tell me this, though, in case I'm really dense here. You weren't my wife, my best friend, mother of my child. You were my slave?
That's how it felt, son. Trapped. I kept trying to tell you, but you never heard me. This was the only way you'd hear me. I don't want to do the show anymore. It's too strained. Everybody knows we're separated. It's ridiculous. I gave CBS my notice.
What? What? No. See, we've got contracts and we've got record deals.
You know what? I gave everyone notice, okay? We'll finish the season on the show and then that's it.
This Geffen's idea.
No. I want out. Can't you believe I can do anything myself?
Why? You don't love me anymore? That's fine. Why are you doing this, huh? Why are you destroying Sonny and Cher?
Because I don't want to be Sonny and Cher anymore.
Thank you.
For a long time after we broke up, I couldn't find Sonny without Cher. Well, we saw each other through the years because of chastity, but things remained strained. Sometimes cool, sometimes like nothing ever happened. Hello?
Mr. Bono?
Yes?
Hi, I'm calling from the David Letterman Show. We'd like to know if you'd be a guest on David's show.
Oh, well, that's really nice.
With Cher.
Huh. So, what do you think, Mary?
I think you should do it.
I don't know. I'm working with Cher again. It'll just bring up all those old feelings.
Sonny, those feelings are always there. But you moved on. They can't be as painful as they were back then.
Well, you don't know Cher. She can give pain in the strangest ways.
Sonny and I have this strange relationship that no one will ever understand except us, and I'm not even sure I understand it.
I don't either.
All right.
Yeah, well, do you ever think about getting back together again, though?
In what capacity?
Well, get married again.
Well, I don't think Mary would like that.
No, my wife wouldn't like that.
She's pregnant.
And are you friendly with Mary?
Mary, yeah.
And Sonny, are you friendly with her,
Well, your husband?
Oh, well, I'm not even friendly with my husband. What are you trying to get to?
I don't know. Just killing time.
Oh.
All right. Now, is there any chance in hell you'd sing something here together for us? Mm. Come on, huh? Yeah, come on.
Shut up.
But thanks, Paul. Okay, come on. Give it a shot, huh? What do you say? Oh, you'll be great. You'll love it right over there. Come on. Sonny and Cher, folks.
Say we're young and we don't know. We'll find out until we grow. I don't know if all that's true. You got me and baby, I got you. Babe, I got you, babe. I got you, babe. They say our love won't pay the rent before it's earned. Money's all been spent. I guess that's so we don't have a pot, but at least I'm sure of all the things we got. Babe, I got you, babe. I got you, babe. I got flowers.
There was this section in the Reader's Digest, and it was called The Most Unforgettable Character I've Ever Met. And for me, that person is Sonny Bono. And no matter how long I live or who I meet in my life, that person will always be Son for me.
If somebody asked me to say one thing to a lot of people, nobody ever has, but if they asked me to say one thing, I guess I would say, believe in magic, and it'll happen. I thank you for having it happen to me. Thank you, good night, and God bless you.